Hi guys, this is Mina. Today we are going to create objects in SQL Server Management Studio using T-SQL codes. Objects such as databases and tables. At the end of this video, you would know what is a database, a schema, and a table. You'd also learn how to use T-SQL codes to create databases, schemas, and tables. This is our SQL Server Management Studio interface. And one thing you have to know is that tables and schemas reside in databases. So for instance, this is my databases folder. If I open it, all of these are databases. I click on the plus sign, you'd see tables. The tables that we will create will reside under tables, and schemas should reside under security. So in order to write a T-SQL code, you have to first go to new query. And in this canvas, we are going to type out our T-SQL code for creating database first. Because remember, schemas and tables reside in database. Database helps us to collect and structure our data. It helps us to store it in such a way that we can easily retrieve and manipulate it for analysis. Here in SQL Server Management Studio, we have the Object Explorer, and that's where we can find our databases, and it organizes our data so that we can easily retrieve and manipulate it for analysis. So the syntax for creating any object in SQL Server Management Studio is create. So if it's database, create database, and then you give the database a name. So I'm just going to go ahead and type that. Just create database, and the name of the database is student records. That's just the name I came up with. And then you execute. You can click on this execute, or you can click on F5. Command completed successfully. It means that our database has been created. So we can refresh our main database folder, and then we should see our student records created. So there it is. Student records. So under student record database, we are going to create our schema and then create our table. A database schema helps us to logically group all our tables under one qualifying name. So if all our tables are grouped under one name, then we can easily apply security permissions for protecting our tables. So we have to create our schema under the database instead of creating it under the main master database. I'm going to use our newly created database and execute. If you don't want to use code to switch from one database to another, you can just click on this drop down arrow and select the appropriate database. So like I said at first, if you want to create anything at all in SQL Server Management Studio, use create. And this time you're going to create a schema and the name of the schema. I'm going to call it Mega Class and execute. Now you can see that my code has red underlining. If the underlining annoys you, just separate your codes from one another using Go. Now we are going to create our table. Table is a database object structured in the form of rows and columns. So you have rows as the horizontal and columns will be the vertical axis, if you will. And columns in a table can also be referred to as fields, and rows in a table can also be referred to as records. Code for writing a table is create table and then the table name. I'm going to call this table students. Mega class is the schema, and then student is the actual table name. So you have the schema dot, the table name, and then the columns for the table, you need to put it into rounded brackets. The first column is going to be student ID, and you specify the data type, which is an integer. And then if you wish to make it an identity key, you type identity, and it's going to have seed value of 1. Means it's going to start from 1 and it's going to increment by 1. So you're going to have 1, 2, 3 as our student ID. and as a student ID, it's also a primary key. So you just type primary key. Separate by a comma, and then you go to the next column, which will be first name. And the data type is Enversha. Enversha is more like a string of variable length, and it accepts Unicode as well. You need to specify the string length. I'm going to give it 50 and go on to the next column name, which is last name. It's also an Enversha of length 50. Student needs to have age. Age is going to be an integer. You don't need to specify length for an integer. I'm going to have email address. That's an Enversha of length 50. I just want to be consistent in my string length, so no special reason. And how about gender? Enversha or Versha, and the string length is 50. So that's it for our first table. We can go ahead and press F5 or execute to create our first table. So I'm gonna go ahead and create two more tables for our student record database. So I have my table, and this is the schema name, dot the table name instructor. And then these are all columns. So first column is the instructor ID. The data type is an integer, and it's an identity key. And this time I didn't specify primary key here because I want to actually do it in a different way. Primary key is a constraint. So the code for explicitly creating a primary key constraint is constraint, and then you give the constraint a name. So I have constraint, constraint name, and then it's a primary key. And what column is the primary key? Instructor ID. This is also another way for creating a primary key. So you can go ahead and execute, and it should be there as a primary key. Last table I'm going to create is the courses table. So as usual, I have my table name and the columns, and then I want to link the student table and instructor table to the courses table, which means that the primary keys for the student and instructor table should be listed here also as foreign keys. So I already have instructor ID, which is a primary key in the instructor table here. I'm just going to make it a foreign key by typing in foreign key. And then which table does it reference? So it references the instructor table. And then which column in the instructor table? It's the instructor ID. And that's the code for creating a foreign key in another table. I'm going to create another foreign key constraint for the student ID, linking the student table to the courses table. So this time I'm going to use the constraint method, and it's going to be constraint, and the name of the constraint, I'm going to preface it with foreign key, and then the schema name, the foreign key table name, and the primary key table name, and that is a foreign key. What column in the courses table is the foreign key? It's student ID, and it references the student table. Which column in the student table? It's the student ID. Okay, so this is how you can use constraint to also create foreign keys for columns. So we can go ahead and execute this. Okay, so if you want to see these tables, you can refresh the database and go to tables. There we have our tables. You can also go to database diagrams. Well, this is a relational database schema for our student record database. If you want to see the primary and foreign keys associated with each table, we can click on the plus sign beside each table, go to columns, and there we have the key. This is a primary key, course ID, and PK represents a primary key. And also here, instructor ID and student ID are foreign keys. If you do not explicitly state that your columns do not allow nulls, then the system will automatically state that it should allow nulls. So you have null beside each column, but primary key cannot contain null. So that's also because we state the primary key, it says not null. Okay. So for instance, if we do not want any of these columns to be null, we can just type not null. So under security, we go to schemas and we can find our mega class schema. Thank you so much for staying with me on this tutorial and see you in the next one. Have a good day.